Well, bummer.
Just heard that Tom Petty passed away. That fucking sucks. Only 66, too. Classic musician. Anyways, I pulled into the parking spot here to get some groceries. And the car I parked across from here has got Buddy in it. Driving. He was staring right at me a second ago, but there he is. He's freaking. Thought that was hilarious when I pulled in. Anyways.
Hi. That's my bud. Good boy. That's my daddy boy. Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome to Making Clouds with Mudflap. Sorry, Teddy's just looking for a little attention while we're out here in the backyard. Day after the concert. Got the day off. Took Karen's dad to lunch today for his birthday. 84th birthday. It's kind of a nice afternoon. So I thought I'd get out here, smoke one with you, and talk to you a little bit about how the old show went this weekend. It was a Tuesday night concert. There was a show on Monday night. I had a bunch of friends who went Monday night, but me and the wife went on Tuesday night. I have seen Roger Waters 4, 5, 6 times now. I've seen Pink Floyd a couple times without Roger Waters. Got some Bubba Kush here with a little bit of the rosin on the end of that. So we're going to enjoy that and talk to you about the show. Like I said, I've seen Roger Waters numerous times. I seen him the first time with the Pros and Cons of Hitchhiking, which was his first solo album that he did with Eric Clapton on guitar, and he toured with him too, so that was really nice. Second time I seen him was the Radio Chaos tour at Canada's Wonderland in Barrie area. It's north of Toronto. And that show was so freaking good that I went and seen it 8 months later in Hamilton. They played an inside tour. Oh, mosquitoes, they're still out. October the 4th, they're still biting. Yeah, so I went and seen that a couple times. And then I think he came out with Amused to Death, and I don't remember there being a tour for that, but it's quite possible there was, and I just missed it, but I don't really recall seeing a tour for that album. And then he did the Wall tour a few years ago, 2 to 3 years ago. I can't even remember the year, but I went, when that tour started, I went and seen it in the arena in Montreal at the Bell Centre, and then 18 months later, they were in Toronto. Like, they were in Toronto previous to that for the arena show, and then they did it like a stadium show, and they did it at the Sky Dome, which is now called the Rogers Center. What a fucking phenomenal show that was. Like, the first one was really good, the Wall, but the second Wall one was even better in that huge stadium. But man, I never try to miss a Roger Waters show when I get the chance. If you like Pink Floyd, it's not just a concert, it's a show. It's like Karen said, it was like going to the movies because there was so much going on, and they had the huge screen behind the stage. Not the circular one like they used to do, but a huge, huge screen that was so freaking clear. And then right down the center of the arena, running lengthwise, there was this, I don't know, track across the top, I guess. It looked like lighting and speakers and all that. And in the second half, all these screens came down on both sides so that the people on the sides could watch. And just a phenomenal show. I've got some footage of going there and that. I had an edible about half an hour before I got on the GO train. We got on GO train at 5:30. I started eating it a little bit after 5 after I got a coffee. And we got into Toronto 6:30, quarter 7. Walked around for a bit. Got some gum and some mints for the show. Just because of the dry mouth and that. And then we got in close to 7:30, I think. I ate my mushrooms. And then the show was supposed to start at 8 o'clock. Well, 8 o'clock, the big screen comes on, and there's like some lady sitting on the beach looking out at the Mediterranean Sea or something like that. I'm just assuming that because of the Moroccan-type music in the background. Light, mellow music. Barely audible, And then you'd hear some waves, kind of not crashing, but slowly, gently going into the shore, and then the breeze would pick up, and you could see the grass going in the wind. At first, I didn't know if it was me having visuals from the mushrooms or this was actually stuff happening there. And then Karen's like, no, the grass is moving. So that goes on for about 10 minutes, 10, 15 minutes. And after about 10 minutes, the sky starts to darken a little bit. Not that the waves get any bigger, but the sky gets darker and darker. And then this cloud starts coming in and the whole sky turns black. And as this storm moves in, the auditorium goes dark and the band comes out and starts with Speak to Me. And then they do Breathe. Beautiful, beautiful old classic tunes. And then One of These Days, I'm going to cut you with a Max Eugene. That was a fucking cool song. Some of my classics. And Time, great Gig in the Sky, Welcome to the Machine, Deja Vu, The Last Refugee, and Picture That were three songs from the new album, which I have. It's a pretty fucking good album. Didn't really like it at first, but the more I listened to it, the more I enjoyed it. Then they were dead, Wish You Were Here, The Happiest Days of Our Lives, another Brick in the Wall, 2 and 3. Then they took a break. Roger came out, talked to us a little bit, said something about Israel accusing him of anti-Semitic type show. He was quite adamant that he was not anti-Semitic and there was nothing in his show to state that, so there wasn't. It was like a 20-minute break. So I got up and walked around a little bit. We were in the bottom bowl, the very last row on the corner of the arena. And I think that our seats, because there was only four of them right at the end of the stairs, were part of a box if people bought extra tickets or something like that. So there was Karen, she had a railing, and then me. And then the two seats beside us that an older couple had. But my seat was on the stairs so I could stretch my legs out and everything, which I don't usually get to do being 6'5" on that. So that was really nice. But anyways, there was a little door beside Karen. And the odd person would come in and out and I thought, what the fuck is that door for? So in intermission, I went in there. And what it was a balcony over the concourse, which was kind of like the private booth or private box. Balcony, access balcony, but there was bathrooms in there so we didn't have to go down with everybody else and stand in line. Plus there was a bartender and a bar up there too, so we could buy booze up there too. I had one beer at the beginning of the show, but at $12, $12.50 for a tall boy of Canadian, it's just a little bit too much. There was wine there, a 9-ounce glass of wine was $17.50, but yeah. So I'm sitting there walking around using the bathroom. It's still at break and there was only one other person in the bathroom, so that was pretty freaking cool. And that's when I looked in the mirror. Never look in the mirror when you do mushrooms, and realized how really good I was feeling. Karen took a selfie of us in between the sets. The first picture wasn't quite as good. She said, yeah, I need to take another one. You look way too wasted in this first one. So that was kind of cool. Second set, they come out and start playing some of my fucking favorite stuff. I'm a big, big fan of the Animals album, Pink Floyd. I think that was truly one of the first ones I got into. And they did Dogs and Pigs, three different kinds, which was just fucking phenomenal. So I'm getting goosebumps now just freaking talking about it. Then they did Money and Us and Them, which the tour is named after. And then they did another song called Smell the Roses, which was from Roger's new album. Then they did Brain Damage. That was fucking phenomenal. I've got some footage of that. Well, Karen took some footage on the iPhone. It's fairly decent, better than the phone I had. So I'm going to throw all the pictures and the footage that we have in after our little talk here. But we'd get together, have a little chat. Anyways, after Brain Damage, they did Eclipse. And then they went off for the cheering and encore. They came out and did Mother and Comfortably Numb for the encores. Now, we left about halfway through Comfortably Numb. It was 11 o'clock. So the show kind of started at 8 there, like I said, with the visuals and that. We left at 11. The first GO train I was leaving after there to get back to the Burlington Hamilton area was 11:13. So I figured it was enough time to have a smoke before I got on the train. We got there was like 5 minutes left. Got on the train, no rush of people. I think as we got on the train, the show must have been just letting out. So a few stragglers got onto the train before the doors closed, and we left at 11:13. And yeah, it wasn't that busy on the train. Another hour and 10 minutes back to the car. A quick little smoke, and then stopped for coffee, and we came home. It was home 2:15, 2:30. So yeah, the dog's very happy to see us, obviously, because I didn't take them anywhere. Instead of spending the day in Toronto, we just decided to go later, and that way we didn't have to take the dogs anywhere or have someone come look after them or whatnot, because they were only 10, 11 hours alone. No messes in the house. We weren't expecting any, but if they do, it's understandable, because they don't usually get left alone that long. So other than that, great freaking night out with the wife. Couple things that were neat for her. She'd never been on the GO train before, and that's double-deckered, so we sat on the top. She got to see a little bit of the area, so it's kind of nice, because obviously with us moving to BC soon, she's not going to get a lot of chances to do that. And she even stated, oh, this is probably like one of the last big events that we'll ever do like this. And truthfully, yeah, it probably will, because we don't do concerts together, the two of us, very often. I really wanted her to see that show, though. I did take her to see Pink Floyd at the Exhibition Stadium back in the 90s with David Gilmour, and she really enjoyed that. Actually, she wasn't a Pink Floyd fan until that show, and she realized, wow. But yeah, well, a good day. Very nice day. We did some working out in the afternoon. Had a quick little meal, and then went to the show, and then today was the day off. Felt really good when I got up this morning. It's like, wow, I didn't even go to a concert and do mushrooms. I was up like by 8:30, so only like 4 or 5 hours of sleep. We did some stuff, and we went for lunch with Karen's dad, and then when I got home, I think that's when it hit me. It's like, oh, I'm just beat. Felt the lethargic and all that, so. But yeah, great freaking time. Other than that, our doobie's done here. I'm feeling pretty freaking good. And my doggies are wandering aimlessly, so I'm going to attend to them. Hope you enjoyed the story of the concert. I'll throw some footage of some songs and a couple pictures in here. Hope you enjoy it. Thanks for coming out. Grab yourself a doobie if you haven't already. Hopefully you do. Finish smoking it while watching this. Be proud of your cloud. See you next time.
Sun's out, and we got sunglasses on. We got a full tank of gas, a half a pack of smokes, a big old friggin' crispy, special crispy, and probably half to three quarters of a gram of mushrooms. We're on a mission. Off to see Roger Waters in Toronto. Yeah, baby.
Hey.
What?
I don't want to be an ass here, but you got the tickets?
That's funny you should ask that. Last concert I went to, Metallica with Buddy, your buds, asked the Matt's exact same way almost, and he had forgot the tickets. Let me see if I remember. That's funny. Yeah, buddy.
All yeah, right.
Got them both even. Guess you're going. Off to the ACC. It's 20 after 3. Stop and grab a coffee, probably in Brantford, chow down the edible, get to Burlington, grab the GO train, Aldershot or something, somewhere around there, and zippy on into downtown Toronto if we're early enough, grab a quick bite to eat, if not, on to the show. Starts at 8, don't be late, see you there, or if we stop on the way. Stopped at the Hortons, you can see behind me, for a coffee and a pee. Got a smoke. We're in Brantford, about 40 minutes away, probably from catching the GO train. got into Hamilton yet, and this is the traffic we were dealing with. 5 o'clock. Just jam-packed. I think we're probably about, maybe 15 clicks away from the ghost patient. That's right, and we're eating edibles. Anyways, we'll be signing off for now. This is what we call Hamilton Mountain. This is what the mountain.
Ontario.
And like. Ontario Mountain is, yeah. While we're here at the ghost station, we're gonna head in, catch our train. We're here for the 5:30 one, actually, a little half an hour earlier if we get in there right away. If not, we'll miss it and have to stick around for half an hour. So I am foregoing a smoke break to get on this particular train. We can break later. And as you see, I just had an edible anyway, so there we go.
Oh, that guy's got a Montreal Canadiens thing on his car.
Yeah, baby. Abs on the way.
We'll be right back.